Find your voice, shout it from the rooftops, and keep doing it until the people that are looking for you find you. We're always being told, find your voice. When I was younger, I never really knew what this meant. I used to worry a lot about voice, wondering if I had my own. But now I realize the only way to find your voice is to use it. It's hardwired, built into you. Talk about the things you love. Your voice will follow. When the late film critic Roger Ebert went through several intense surgeries to treat his cancer, he lost the ability to speak. He lost his voice, physically and permanently. Here was a man who made a great deal of his living by speaking on television, and now he couldn't say a word. In order to communicate with his friends and family, he'd have to either scribble his responses on a pad of paper or type on a Mac and have the awkward computer voice read it out loud through his laptop speakers. Cut off from everyday conversation, he poured himself into tweeting, posting on Facebook, and blogging at RogerEbert.com. He ripped out posts at a breakneck speed, writing thousands and thousands of words at everything he could think of. His boyhood in Urbana, Illinois, his love for Steak and Shake, his conversations with famous movie actors, his thoughts on his inevitable death. Hundreds and hundreds of people would respond to his posts, and he would respond back. Blogging became his primary way of communicating with the world. On the web, my real voice finds expression, he wrote. Ebert knew his time on this planet was short, and he wanted to share everything he could in the time he had left. Mr. Ebert writes as if it was a matter of life and death, wrote journalist Janet Maslin. Because it is. Ebert was blogging because he had to blog, because it was a matter of being heard or not being heard, a matter of existing or not existing. It sounds a little extreme, but in this day and age, if your work isn't online, it doesn't exist. We all have the opportunity to use our voices, to have our say, but so many of us are wasting it. If you want people to know about what you do and the things you care about, you have to share.